to do a review on McAllister, one of my faves. She just, with Thomas, just, you know, you can look it up on Rumble, McAllister and Thomas. She says something about this Black Swan movie where the guy, I guess a handler, seduces her, but does not have sex with her, just awakens her lust and greed or something like that.
And demonic possession. Its main message is that you can't achieve greatness without selling yourself to the devil and connecting with the evil inside.
You can't achieve greatness without selling your soul to the devil.
She was unable to develop and is still a child psychologically and sexually. Her bedroom's wallpaper is covered with butterflies.
I guess it's from the movie Black Swan.
When she is ripe and
with Leroy and Nina,
her handler Leroy, the king in French, I didn't know that, enters her life and introduces her to evil with the help of Lilith, right? So all this stuff.
Let me just get to one of her. She's just coming close to just something I want to talk
gods
about.
Gods and goddesses and all that. He seduces her, but doesn't have sex with her. He just awakens her lust and greed. In a key scene, we see Leroy.
There you go. He seduces her, but he doesn't have sex with her. He just awakens her lust and greed. Think about Weinstein and Epstein. What do they both have in common? They masturbated in front of their women. They awaken the lust and greed. The maneuvering swine who want to make it in showbiz. And they, that's where the saying, you know, they have what it takes. Because their religion is, what it takes is money. Because they look at you and say, well, that person is going to, you know, we'll see what they'll do for this amount of money. And then that Jewfrey girl, she was called a peasant first. And then she was a breeder. But basically they awaken the greed in you. What's already there, and unfortunately a lot of people who had hard times, divorced parents, no money. Yeah, it's easy to be a little greedy, don't you think, or want some easy money? But that's how they awaken it. But then they'll masturbate in front of these girls. They don't want to knock them up or have sex with them because they think that masturbating in front of the girl is not really having sex with them. So I just wanted to address that because, you know, I have to admit that happened to me when I was young with one of the richest men in the city I was living in. He accused me of being a peasant, and I didn't take offense to it at the time. I thought it was a compliment. Then he showed me a really expensive apartment with a solid gold sink, and then he later whipped out off his belt and started doing it to himself. The only way out was through an elevator. So anyways, I see that seems to be very formulaic. And I'm just saying I'm confirming what this is a tactic. And it has nothing to do with, it has a lot to do with just, you know, mind games and all that. But it's across the board. Holy. Now. That's why learning about malignant narcissism is very much across the board. Unless you're getting your information from the new people, it will not be right. But the second thing she said was something about the Moonies. And I have an experience with the Moonies, too. They tried to recruit me back in the 80s. And what they do is they have plants in the room of about, say you got six people in that room. Two of us are just strangers off the street. And the four are planted in the room, smiling and clapping and everything that the video says. So that's how they get the recruits, is if you're susceptible to other people clapping. That's why I love what Rex Reed says at the beginning of Lost in America. He says, they said, don't you like the laugh track or people laughing around you? He says, if something's funny, I'll laugh. I don't need to hear a whole bunch of other people laughing. We all need a little more Rex Reed in our lives, don't you think? So that's just a shout out. I wanted to respond to that real quick because, I mean, the little time is flying. And we got to grab on to things that are not changing. Those are the things that are going to help us through this shit. This quagmire. We are in a desert, aren't we?